Hello everyone, I'm Jean, the TCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. Here is my online class for ENT and eye problems for TCM practitioner and acupuncturist. The book we use I put below here. I can help students to study and review for the class. Let's start.
The first illness we're talking about on the outside eyelids. So basically we have some grass in there. So if the grass getting swollen or infections, that will cause some problems. And it is a very, very common problem. Sometimes you can find some people that are bumped in the eyelid area. So that basically is a infection kind of problem happens in the eyelid glass. So that's the mainly problem happens in there. So this one. Clinical symptoms. So like this picture. So locally swollen and painful, and sometimes they may have some pulse inside. Yeah, runny, swollen, nodules inside. That's the mainly problem. They also happens the upper part of the eyelid. Or possible happens on our part. So these kind of problems, like we say before, generally say they just local problems. They are not blocking the vision. So patients normally don't have vision problems. So let's talk about different patterns or maybe different reasons cause the problem. The first pattern we're talking about the wind heat pattern. So orifice problems, it usually is external pattern combination with the internal pattern. But some case is more external pattern. Some case is more internal pattern. So this pattern we say is external pattern. Yeah, wind heat evading. So wind heat evading, we're talking about the symptoms here. We're talking about the generally local symptoms. So that's we're talking about all the orifice problems. Basically, their symptoms separate with two parts. One part is the local symptom. Another part is the generally pattern symptom. So locally, pretty similar, like we talked about before, rhinitis, but it's not a severe rhinitis. Yes, slightly rhinitis and swollen, and maybe itchiness. It's not that severe kind of pain. And if we touch the local eye, we can find some hardness in there, like some nodules under. So that's the local symptoms. Yeah, local symptoms. And the pattern symptoms, when we're talking about the heat pattern, it's pretty similar, like we're talking about common cold, wind heat pattern. Yeah. So thus, we're talking about like a common cold, wind heat pattern. Patients fever, aversion to cold at the same time, and possible have headache, and possible have body ache, runny nose, still possible. If we're looking for the tongue, if we're looking for the tongue, we say first 2 days, tongue not changing. After 2 days, maybe lightly red tongue and lightly yellow tongue coating. But the pulse, floating and rapid. So floating pulse means external reason, external pattern. And the rapid means heat up. So that's we say external heat. Same meaning is wind heat. So treatment principle you know already, Remove passenger wind heat, you can add in like a benefit eyes behind it. So then we talk here about the herbs we use or formula we use. So we talk here about modified from Encyclopedia. Still same the formula when we talk here about the common cold. And then we can add in some herbs, especially go to the eyes. So for all class, the formula basically I just follow that book. But if the formula is required by CDCMA, you need to remember. Originally formula in there. If the formula not required by CDCMA, you are not necessary to remember. So we still prepare for board exam. So certainly in Encyclopedia in our CDCMA list, pretty common used formula, we need to remember original ingredients. Common use dosage. Dosage part, usually they are not special to ask you, but if it's not special kind of herbs, you just put like 10 to 15, something like that. Very good. But some special herbs, like thousand herbs, we couldn't use over dosage. And some herbs pretty heavy, like shigao, you may need a bigger dosage. So that's generally dosage part. But you need to remember all the ingredients in the formula. I think some of you may pass the board exam already. I'm not sure. But generally say in board exam, just give you an example of what they will do you. They may give you a case, and then they say, for treat this patient, they would like to use like which formula. They even sometimes give you formula's name. And then they say, one of the ingredients they don't have. Like right now, we try to use Encyclopedia. But some of the ingredients we don't have right now. And then they ask you if some others you can add in there. So that means you need to remember all the ingredients inside. They may give you some herbs in there already. If you don't remember like which herbs in there, and they ask you use other herbs inside, so you don't know which herbs not in the formula. So that's why we need to remember all the formula ingredients for your board exam. For your clinical practice, certainly that's easy. You can check in the book and then you find the ingredients. But truly for board exam, you need to remember all the herbs. But not necessary for the dosage part. So here we use Encyclopedia for this pattern. And when we talk here about the modified, so with a if severe kind of wind passenger emitting, we can put sun ear and juhua. So sun ear is the leaf of the herb, and juhua is the flower of the herb. They are pretty nice. So especially for juhua, it's very good for the eyes. So they can go to slightly, go to upper part of the body and benefit the eyes. So that's what we can add in there. So if like most severe heat, we say this pattern is wind heat pattern. Yeah, that's what we generally say. But clinically, sometimes it's a big wind, small heat. Sometimes possible, big heat, small wind. So it's depending what kind of situation. And if severe kind of heat in there, we can add jinhua inside of jinhua. Inside of jinhua. Jinhua, let it be warm. Yeah, let it be warm, nice. So we remove jinhua and add jinhua. And jinhua and lianjiao. And we also plus some huangjin. Yeah, we also plus some huangjin to clear heat. So it's more severe kind of pain in there. Yeah, it's more severe kind of pain in there. That means maybe some blocking causes some blood stasis. So we can add in luxiang and moyao. Yeah, severe kind of pain. So basically, this pattern which is modified from yinxiaozi. Then we're talking about the second pattern. When we're talking about the passenger heat here means most severe heat. Yeah, most severe heat. So we didn't especially talking about where the heat coming from, but truly heat is most severe. So we can see the symptoms here. So locally, still redness, but compared with wind heat pattern, it's more red and more swollen and more painful. So that's locally. Even some burning sensation in the like eyelid area and possible some pulse show up. Yeah, some pulse. So that's a severe kind of heat. Yeah, severe kind of heat. And other symptoms. We say in that kind of heat can cause patient fever, but pay attention here, fever only. We didn't talk about aversion to wind or cold. Means this kind of heat coming from internally. It is internal heat. Yeah, it is heat. And thirsty. Yeah. Heat damage body fluid causes people thirsty. And the body fluid deficiency causes people constipation. So these kind of constipation, generally say we're talking about the dry stool. And scanted yellow urination. Because the heat inside, yeah, heat inside. And the truly tongue will be right tongue yellow coating, and the rapid pulse. So we are not specially talking about where the heat coming from, but it is truly internal heat. So for treatment principle, we need to remove, we say, toxic heat, some wrong words here, yeah, you can correct it. Yeah, remove toxin heat and purge fear. And we say benefit the eyes, you know. So this heat kind of condition, we can use huang lian jie du tang modifier. Huang lian jie du tang. Still remember what's the original formula? It is modified formula in here. Do you remember original formula with huang lian jie du tang?
It's the three huangs plus jitsu.
Yes, good. Yeah, good. Yes. So originally formula is three huangs plus jitsu. They still have huang lian, still have huang qin and huang bai. Where's jitsu? They didn't put the jizu here, but truly we could still keep jizu. Yeah, they remove jizu. Yeah, they remove jizu. I just copy from the book. They remove jizu, but truly we still can keep jizu. But they plus pugongyang. Yeah, pugongyang is glass. Yeah, and zihua didian is kind of glass also. And these two herbs, we talk about grass, leaves, flowers, they are light, they are pretty easily go to upper part of body. They are good for clear heat in the eyes. And then they add in dangui and mudanpi. Yeah. Dangui belong to blood tonify herbs. But they have some function to move in blood, yeah. Especially tail part of the dangui. And the mudanpi here mainly cooling the blood. We still remember in this pattern, the patient has severe kind of pain. Yeah, severe kind of pain. So that's basically something blocking inside, some heat in the blood levels, and blocking the blood. So we are cooling blood and moving blood. And we still can modify it from here, yeah. Even they put a modified formula in there already, then we still can modify it from here. If patient constipation, yeah, severe kind of constipation, we can add da huang, yeah. Da huang is the purging herb, yeah, purging herb. Clear heat from the bowel movement. Yeah. And if patient most thirsty, yeah, most thirsty, we can add tianhuafen. Yeah, we can add tianhuafen. So tianhuafen have function generate the body fluid. And then we're talking about if the eyelid locally have a pupil color. Dark kind of pupil. That means blood stasis. That means blood stasis. So we can add Ru Xiang and Mo Yao. Yeah, Ru Xiang and Mo Yao. Moving blood. Moving blood. So if the pus, like just holding there, yeah, couldn't relieve. Yeah, couldn't relieve. It's holding there. So Zao Jiao Ci. It's a good herb. Zao Jiao Ci is a good herb. To try like the pus coming out. So that's from this pattern, we say passenger heat or heat toxins. So basically, first two patterns is belong to acute pattern. It belong to acute pattern. Suddenly happens, local severe kind of painful, rhinitis swollen. Both the case, they will be recovered after treatment. Yeah, they will be recovered after treatment. But some kind of patient, they may have some underlying body deficiency. Then the problems, like getting better and then come back. Getting better and then come back. So kind of changing to chronic problem. So So these kind of case, even if you look in local lab, it is right knee in the SDO, but it's not that severe kind of right, it might right, and a little bit swollen, and still painful, but all the symptoms is right, it's not that severe. So that's basically we say is chronic problems and couldn't heal. So in this kind of case, you are possible to find other body deficiency symptoms on the side. Maybe spleen deficiency, TNT not working. But just generally body deficiency will cause problems long term in there. So in that kind of case, we say generally spleen qi deficiency that's the main reason. Possible have some spleen qi deficiency symptoms. So generally say we need a tonified qi and renew acid. So the formula here, they call 脱离消毒散. This formula not in your TCM list. So that means you are not necessary to remember the ingredients inside. So basically this formula you can see mainly codified qi and codified blood. And moon blood problem. So that's mainly we say people have the problems for a long term. It's not cured. It must have some deficiency, qi blood deficiency in there. So that's why we use qi tonify and blood tonify. So certainly huang qi is a tonify herb. And bai zhu, wu ling, tonify qi stronger the middle jiang, stronger the spring fungus. And the twin xiu is moving blood, dangui tonify blood and moving blood also. So you can see it look like a half formula, si wu tang, half formula, si jun zu tang. Plus quantity here. Then we can add in zao jiao ci, that's good for renewing pulse. And jin yin hua we talked about already. It's flower, clear heat toxin, Huang qin, basically clear upper jiao heat, mainly clear upper jiao heat. It's still working for middle jiao. But good for abdomen. And the fang feng here. We say these like orifice problems, we're always thinking about external pathogen combination with internal pathogen. So people always say, always get some pathogen invading. That's body junky. So we need add fang feng to protect it. Passenger wind evading. And also you can see fang feng, bai zhu, huang qi together. That's a formula. What formula it is? Do you remember? Three herbs put together. Huang qi, bai zhu, fang feng. Any idea?
Yu ping feng san.
Yes, zhu jiao. Yes. So that's the basic idea here. Yu ping feng san. Protect the body. Protect the body. So that's the idea there. And the Gan Cao harmonize the formula and the tea modified herbs. So when we talk about modified here, so basically they talk about if more redness and more swollen in there, means more heat toxins. And more herbs to go in, clear heat toxins, and the pretty light go to upper part of body, and the lianqiang. Lianqiang still light, it's kind of fluid, but still light, go to upper part of body. And the pair herbs, lianqiang and the jinhua put it together. So that's for this pattern, this pattern. So we say you are not necessary to remember like originally formula for CDC, not in CDCM list the formula, but you should understand it, like why they put the herbs in. So that's the part like a long term. It's not curious. Kind of a deficiency inside, deficiency inside, qi blood deficiency, generally say qi blood deficiency. Then we talking about another one, like vitally middle gel deficiency, vitally middle gel deficiency. So the symptoms and the size still pretty similar, redness, swollen, and some pain in the eyelid. So we say this pattern pretty commonly happens in the children. Because the children's organs, they development a little bit slow compared with the adults. They are not maturity, not a stronger function in there. So that why we're talking about this pattern is pretty common, happens in the children. And so basically you see it is like a nodule there is a little bit smaller. That means hardness nodule there. And easily recurrent. And other symptoms. Is middle jaw weakness and deficiency. Like don't like to eat. And losing stool. And possible abdominal distension. And little bit yellow, dark, complex. And the pale tongue coming from tea deficiency. And thin pulse here, just means deficiency pulse. Weaker pulse. Even think about this, the weaker pulse. So for this pattern, truly we more tonify the middle jaw. Tonify the spleen, tonify the teeth, and remove the pathogen. So the formula we use, Shen Lin Bai Zhu San. Shen Lin Bai Zhu San in our CPCM list. Shen Lin Bai Zhu San in our CPCM list. So we need to remember all the ingredients inside. But generally say, Shen Lin Bai Zhu San is the formula, tonify middle jaw, tonify qi, and remove dampness or phlegm formula. Pay attention here. It is modified Shen Lin Bai Zhu San here. You go to your formula book, try to remember originally Shen Lin Bai Zhu San. For your board exam, you need to find originally Shen Lin Bai Zhu San. Here is modified. Like Lianqiao, Jinhua is modified, especially for eye problems here. But originally, Shen Lin Bai Zhu San, they don't have Lianqiao, don't have Jinhua. So that's the use this one, fortify the middle gel, remove some dummies. And we still modified from here. So we say it's pretty common that happens in the case. And they may have poor appetite. Don't like to eat it. So we can add in some herbs helping digestion. So Shen Qu, Shan Za, Mai Ya, and Jinli Jin. All the herbs in our helping digestion category. And all the herbs pretty safe to use for the case. So we can add in there to help the digestion. And then we're still talking about its most severe kind of heat in there. It will heat most severe. We can add jimu and huangjin together. Jimu and huangjin together. So huangjin we're talking about already. It's good for clear upper jaw heat. Jimu is usually we use maybe a little bit more for clear kind of deficiency heat. But jimu, the function is more mild. It's more safe to use for the children. So we combination jimu and huangjin together, we clear heat. So that's we talking about like we make decoctions, retreat. Basically for these kind of problems, we can combination use some herbs externally to treat also. So that we can put some herbs like externally. So thus we say if damp heat, in there, like something just happens, and we can just wash it with the hot water, And later on, if more infections on the eyes area, we can put some Xionghuang powder mixed with the vinegar. Xionghuang is external use the herbs only. We never use Xionghuang internally. Let it be often. But it can clear heat. So we mix the Xionghuang powder with the vinegar and then put topically and like a thick air. And we also can use Jugunyin. Like washing the hand or maybe like a steel can mix the with like some water. Like we cook the Jugunyin first. Or even you can grind the Jugunyin and put some water over the eye. Locally. So that's basic.